Namaste, my dear children. I am very happy to see you all again in today's science class. Let us begin our science class for today. So today we are going to continue our clothes lesson. Okay, children. So before we start the class, let's have a short recall. So recall questions. Shall I ask you? You have to answer me. Okay, what do you mean by fibers, children? Fibers are small thread-like structures which in turn will make the thread. And threads makes the clothes, right? Very good, children. Next question. What are the two types of fibers? Yes, you are right, children. They are natural fibers and synthetic fibers. Very good. Now, tell me, what are the natural fibers? They are plant fibers and animal fibers. Right, children? Okay. So, can you say one example for plant fiber? Very good. Cotton, jute, hemp, all these comes under plant fibers. Then what about animal fibers? Yes, the wool and the silk fibers comes under animal fibers. Where do we get wool from? We get wool from sheep. You are right, children. Where do we get silk, ma? Yes, we get the silk from silkworm. Okay, children, let us move on for today's class. So today what we are going to see? We are going to see about the types of clothes. Okay, children. So people wear different varieties of clothes based on their needs and the weather of the place. Okay. The weather may be a hot weather or a cold weather. Okay, children. So hot weather, in hot weather, what type of clothes we can wear, children? We can wear cotton or light synthetic clothes, isn't it, children? In cold weather, what kind of clothes we can wear, children? We can wear wool or thick synthetic fibers. Okay, children? Now, let us see the next point. During hot weathers, that is when the sun is very hot during the summer season, we will wear some clothes, right? Those clothes protect us from the heat, and clothes also absorb the sweat and keeps us cool. During summer we feel very hot, no? So these clothes, the cotton clothes that we wear, will absorb the sweat and keeps us cool. And we wear light colored clothes made of cotton or linen. Okay, children? Now, let us see the next type of weather. So, next we have the cold weather. That is during winter season. So, in cold weather, clothes protect us from the cold. Clothes keep the body warm. Okay, children? We wear dark colored clothes made of wool or synthetic fibers. See, we are wearing dark colored clothes during the cold weather. During rainy season, people will wear what kind of clothes? Waterproof clothes. The waterproof clothes protect us from the rain. See, we are happily playing in the rain, isn't it? But we should not play in the rain. Otherwise, we will feel sick, isn't it? So, we wear synthetic clothes which are waterproof. Clothes keep us dry and comfortable during that time. Now, children, I said during the summer season, we should wear light colored clothes, and during the cold weather, that is the winter season, we should wear dark colored clothes. So, why do you think that we should wear dark colored clothes during winter and light colored clothes during the summer? Do you know, children? It is because during summer, the sun will be very hot, isn't it? So, always the dark colored clothes okay children, that is why we have to wear dark colored clothes during the winter and light colored clothes during the summer. Now, why should we wear dark colored clothes during winter season? Because during winter the climate will be very very cold, isn't it? So your body will be having some heat in your heat within you, isn't it? Your body will be having some heat. This heat should be retained, isn't it? This heat will not go away from the body if you wear the dark colored clothes. But if you wear light colored clothes, it will easily go out and you will feel very cold. Okay? So now, let us see the next point. Now we are going to study about uniforms. So you all know about uniforms. We all wear uniforms, isn't it children? All the school children will wear uniforms. So we wear the uniform and we feel very happy to come to school with the uniform, isn't it children? So likewise, many other people also will wear uniform. We will see what is that, who are those who are wearing uniforms. The chefs. What do you mean by chef, ma? One who cooks, isn't it? That is professionally one who cooks in the hotels and all, they are called as chefs. So they wear this kind of uniform. They wear a hat on their head and all. Why? Because a hat should not fall on the foot, isn't it? So then the next thing is sports person. The sports person to identify which team they wear uniform. And next thing is sailor. So sailor, one who sails the ships and all, they are called as sailors. So they wear uniforms. And the next one is fire fighters. So one who works to put off the fire in the fire engine, those persons also wear such kind of uniforms. You might have seen all these uniforms, isn't it children? Okay. Now we will see about the national costumes or folk dress. So in some countries people wear national costumes. So what are they we are going to see? In India, what are the folk dress? What are the national costumes we are wearing? We are going to see. Okay, that is in different region, that region people will be wearing a separate cloth. Okay, so that is called as folk dress. So see, dhoti. So we wear dhoti and ghagra. This is ghagra and sari. So most of the Indian ladies wear sari. Then this is angrakha. This is angrakha. So this, we have completed our today's class children. So complete your worksheets and send it in your WhatsApp group. Thank you.